I am David Lorenzo. I work as a Power Platform lead and architect in Prodware in Spain. Also, I am MVP on Power App since this past August. So I have luckily to have in Seattle this year. I want just to present our Spanish community Warandina Tech, just in case you want to learn content in Spanish. Also, we do a lot of events there. And there you have also my LinkedIn contact, just in case you want to get in touch. Okay, so today we are presenting a hotel reservation assistant. I have built this this demo since about November, adding new features. So this is the current schema of the solution. It is all orchestrated with Copilot Studio. We get on the top side, we have the four operations to get a hotel reservation done. So you have to get the available zones on the system, you have to get the hotel availability in one of the zones, you get then select a hotel, find the hotel offer, the prices, the meals, and then select the room that you want to book, and then confirm the reservation. So that all with an interface of Power Automate flows and goes into the hotel PMS, in this case Dataverse, but as you know, the hotel PMS property management system can be any interface, any system outside Power Platform, and then you have the interface in Power Automate to just get connected to the outside system. Then as a hotel reservation assistant, one of the things you want to know is maybe find things and activities to do nearby the hotel in the zone that you are going on vacation. So you can connect in this way some websites. I focus on my region in Canary Island. We have two great islands to get on vacation, Tenerife and Gran Canaria. And then I get the official websites from the government of Tenerife and Gran Canaria, and then connect one of them through a knowledge source directly using the website connector. And then another one, we do web scrapping agent. I would like to present this in detail in another community call because it deserves a 15 minutes slot to present this well. But in summary, we get go with an agent in Python. We go to the website, scrap the content, and then improves that with Azure OpenAI, and then indexing Azure AI Search. So we have a knowledge source connected from the Copilot Studio to Azure AI Search that I will show you in a moment. And then in a last but not least, we have a get the weather information with the MSN Weather API. And then we have two custom connectors that connect to Google Places and Google Geocoding APIs to get nearby restaurants on the hotel surrounding area. Okay, so that's just for the next community call. I would like to present this in detail. This is the indexing process for the web scrapping agent. And then I have another gem for a third community call that I want to present this agent also integrated in a custom website connected through direct line API. And then we can do a speech to text and text to speech thing using JavaScript SDK. But that is for the future. So we go directly to the demo. And then we have here a Copilot Hotel Reservation Assistant. Okay, as I mentioned before, we have some knowledge source. Here we connect to public websites about Gran Canaria. And then we have also a Azure AI Search connection through a index. Okay, this index is connected or is filled up with another agent. Okay, the web scrapping agent that I promised to show you. But in this case, we are augmenting the content that we scrap from the website using Azure OpenAI. We get a more powerful and more detailed description about the activities. And then we index that, we vectorize, and then we connect this knowledge source so we can get the information here. Just to give you an overview, here are the zones available in the system. We have a model-driven app that shows we will working with Tenerife, we have some hotels in Tenerife here, and then we have some hotel prices too. And then we have, of course, the meals and the prices and so on. And then we end up by receiving the hotel reservation. So let's try, and then we want to tell the system, I want to go holidays. Just to mention, are you using the preview of Copilot Studio? They have changed recently the orchestration engine. So I see some changes. So this loader is new. And then, I see some changes on the system. So I want to show you, this is blocked. All right, now. So we get here what zones are available to reserve a hotel. Let's see. All right, so the first flow is going away, and then we get so these things are new. I don't know what this means. This is from the new orchestration engine, but okay, we get back the zones that we have in the system: La Palma, Vancouver, Tenerife, and Gran Canaria. That you can see it match the zones that we have in the Dataverse table. So now I continue to the next phase, and then I tell that I want to go to Tenerife. And then it should launch the next flow that is going to the hotels table and filtered out by the Tenerife hotels. And then we intercept back the response, and we use the adaptive cards to show up. So I recommend you take a look at this adaptivecards.ai.io, and then you go to Designer, and you can really have a look at the new card templates that you have here. I just follow with one of these templates, doing some modifications, and you can get beautiful response like this in your Copilot. So let's go forward, and then let's do a reservation for the Hotel Alabama. I just, by the way, recommend you to visit Tenerife, and this is one of the best hotels in the island. Just here, I have selected the hotel. I have selected the destination, so I need a check-in, check-out date, please, and then a PAX number to go to. With adaptive cards, we can select check-in date, check-out date, and then PAX number, and then we go to full. Let's take a full board. Yeah, so this is again receiving the response on the flow, and then I intercept with the JSON back, and then plug in into an adaptive card. Okay, so let's complete the reservation, and then we get the last form. We autofill the user logged in with the logged in user information, and then just put in here my phone number, and then confirm the booking. So this is the last reservation step. We get the localizer, and then we can try to find them here in the hotel reservations. There you go. And then we have all the information about the reservation that we just done. Okay, with the localizer, check-in, check-out date. We have the hotel information here. Just take a look, so beautiful. And then, okay, we have done the reservation. Now I would like to know about the restaurants nearby. So can you show me nearby restaurants on a 5 kilometer radius? Then this, if it works, it should go to the, here it should go to and take the dynamic chaining process, because we have two connectors to the Google Places API. All right, this is connect quas filters. Okay, It's a connection content filter thing here. Let's put for. Okay. So here it works like getting the Hotel Obama. As you can see here, and then get the coordinates and then call to the search nearby restaurants on these coordinates and get the response back. So let's try to Hotel Obama Tenerife. Yeah, so let's do a clean process here. Can you find nearby restaurants to Hotel Obama Tenerife? Radius 3. Okay, it's doing a content filter. I don't know why. So this is one of the scenes that have changed. Then let's take a look here. In the settings, generative AI, high, okay, low. Let's do that. This has been changed in these days. That's one of the preview things that I worry about it. So can you find nearby restaurants to Hotel Obama Tenerife in a 5 kilometer radius? Okay. All right, so it doesn't want to go, but this should show up a list of restaurants and then the link to the Google Maps. Let's try to find what activities can I do nearby. And then this should call to the Azure AI Search. All right, so it gets okay. All right, so this is calling the Azure AI Search Index, and then is getting the information back. And then if you click here, you go to the Web Tenerife information. Okay, that is taking the context also from the conversation. All right, and then I just want to show you the last feature on what is the weather. Okay, in this case, it's taking also the context of the conversation and taking the weather from Tenerife using the forecast for today, the MSN Weather API, and then it's giving you the weather. I have to check for the next time why is this content filter is happening just today. So this should be connecting here, is connecting to the Google Places API, and then getting back the coordinates and then passing the coordinates through the next call. And then here it should be getting the information, but I think they added some content filter thing in the way, and then I have to check what the response is in order to fix that. But okay, we can back over to here. So we have seen so far these features. We have done a get some search hotel availability and hotel offer and confirm the reservation. We have found some activities to do in the knowledge source. Okay, we have used Web Tenerife, which is Azure AI Search indexed, and then we have getting the weather of Tenerife just to get the sunny days here in the island. Then I will back to you, David. Just thank you. Just you can try Copilot Studio here, ak.ms/try Copilot Studio, just in case you are free to do. And then thank you for your time. Hope to be you in the next call.